Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, I want to talk about Jobsite box for ammo storage. Well, why not? So let's just get right into this and talk about this. So basically, if you are a gun owner, a responsible armed citizen, you should technically have, I'm going to call it a plateau of ammunition inventory. I'm not going to get into what that means or how to do that. I did a video 2 years ago when we were going through that bad ammo shortage, and I did a video that pissed everybody off because everyone was saying, you're trying to quote unquote flex, you're flexing. I'm like, what? No, I'm trying to give you a concept. But anyways, you should try to have an ammo plateau. So for me personally, I've been doing this since the late 90s, but it wasn't until 2013, I think, is when I got into an ammo discipline, meaning I was buying ammo on a regularly scheduled occurrence, and I would reach a plateau, and I would ensure that that plateau would never dip down. So I do have quite a bit of ammunition that's stored in an actual safe. However, it got to the point where that safe is full, so I started using ammo cans, and then I realized now I got all these ammo cans everywhere. You know, I should try to centralize ammunition. So yes, I do have an actual safe for just ammo, but then I had all these ammo cans. I'm like, it's a mess. So I tried this concept. It's not the best. It's disorganized if I just do it like this, but it's a work in progress. But I'm curious, job site boxes. I see a lot of other guys out there using them as gun safes, actually, making them incognito, you know, covering them up, putting them in other locked rooms, and then they lock it with the padlocks. Honestly, I would not use a job site box for gun storage, for long-term gun storage, that is. But you can let me know what you think about that concept. Me personally, I like to use an actual gun safe or gun vault, like a Liberty Fat Boy Extreme. Those are very good. That thing is not going anywhere. But I just got something called a Securit cabinet. That is very, very, very interesting because you can have your rifles all ready to go when you open up the door. They're like all lined up, stacked very nicely. In a Liberty Fat Boy Extreme, we'll say it's more for storage. So it's not fast, easy access to your rifle if you open up that kind of a safe. Things are all over the place. But it's got the space for a lot of handguns. But for rifles, you gotta get creative. But that's a whole nother video. I just got off topic, and I don't like showing a gun safe because it shows like the entire like collection inventory. So I don't know. Maybe I'll do a video on the Securit because right now I have it in a quote unquote ready room where I just put in like 6 rifles in there, all nicely lined up, spaced out. I got some revolvers in there. It's kind of a neat concept, but it is a cabinet. So it must be secured to the floor and wall to be quote-unquote secured. If it's not, then it doesn't really do any good. So I'm thinking about how I'm going to utilize a secured cabinet, but another video. So the job site box, I think it's a pretty cool concept to use it for ammunition storage. Would I go out and buy one of these at full price? I don't think so. I was able to get one of these, so I don't know. I'm not really sure. I'm still working through the motions here, but what I'm trying to get your guys' thoughts, because people were asking me, hey, I got a lot of ammo. How should I store it? In ammo cans? And I was like, I don't know. I tried it with the ammo. See, I have an actual safe that has a ton of ammo in there, like with the ammo cans in there. But after that, I outgrew that. Yeah, I started having external cans everywhere, which proved to be very, very, very cumbersome when I had to move stuff. So it was like, I was like, why did I do it like this? And why should I store it like this in all different ammo cans? So, all right, let's get right into this. So this is a rigid, it's a standard old Home Depot job site box. It's a smaller version. I would get the larger one because then I could put even more ammunition in here. But this is what I had available to me. Again, would I get this brand new? I don't think I would, but I'm not sure yet. Maybe I would. We'll see. But this is a job site box. Has 2 different padlocks on there to lock it. And yeah, someone can drill those locks out, but whatever. It's in a secure area. It's out of the way. Nobody knows. You get the picture. But So it's got two padlocks that kind of secure it from prying eyes, we'll say. So here, let's open this thing up. And we can take a look at this. So as you can see, this is some of my ammunition in a job site box. It's not organized. That's what kind of kills me on this, because in the safe, everything is nicely organized. In this job site box, this is like the ammunition that was all in those ammo cans that I threw in here. But I do have some pails of ammo here and there. So as you can see, this isn't the most ideal. However, if you need to secure your ammunition, which you should, you could put it in a job site box like this and just lock it. And if you have children, you know, keep them away from this stuff. Their friends, keep them away. If there's some guy, scumbag lowlife, that really wants to come in there and steal stuff, they're gonna get in. There's no way around it. But you can harden your fortress easily with the technology of today, with cameras, sensors, okay, so on and so forth. You got options. But this is just like, if you look at this, it's just stuff that's just kind of thrown in here. So this ammunition in this box for me is mainly just ammo that I'm just storing. That's it. I'm rarely ever going to open this up and try to get ammo out of here, because my ammo safe has the ammo that I'm constantly rotating through, if you get what I'm trying to say. But for storage, and this is like, I don't know if you want to call it overrun from my ammo safe, I'm putting it in this job site box for now. And I even have some more in another cabinet that just houses ammunition and some uppers that I have. But all firearms are secured in a safe. But I don't know, let me just check this out. Got some 300 blackout that I'm not gonna be, that could be for next, well, all right. I gotta stay on track here, because I know a lot of you hate when I ramble and go off track. But anyways, this is what it looks like. It goes in pretty deep. I mean, I don't even know how much, there's a lot of 5.56 I got here. I think every caliber, 5.56, you got 9mm, 38 Special, 357 Magnum, 10mm, 45 ACP. I think that's about it. The 308 stuff is in a cabinet. 308 12 gauge is in somewhere else. But this is just a general idea. Also, you definitely need to keep things dry for ammunition. Now granted, back in the day, I used to keep ammunition in a basement that was very damp and things would get wet, but that's so not ideal, but the ammunition did work, but that kind of sucked because that basement would get wet and water would get in there, and I was just like, oh well, this is the only place I can keep my ammo at that time. This was like 20 years ago. These things here are pretty neat, okay, and these are like dehumidifiers, and I just throw them inside this job site box here, just to make sure the moisture doesn't get out of control. So it's like dehumidified. And this thing here is another, I don't even know, I don't really even use this. I just threw this in there. Barska, whatever. But these are pretty interesting. I like these. And I got a bunch of these here. And I use these in the other ammo safe. I use these. And these are called, Afloia. I got this off Amazon, and I think this thing really does work. It comes with this base station that will dry out the, we'll call them, tubes there after they become, this will say, wet. So that this color will turn to black. That's when you know you gotta recharge them and put them on that base station and dry out the stuff, you know, the silica in here. But these work out well. You're gonna wanna have something like that in your ammo, wherever you store your ammo. So let me just kinda give you a closer look here. This is the padlock. But basically you can just put your ammunition here. So I am curious, do you guys, what do you think about storing ammo in a job site box like this? There's no way someone's gonna lift this thing and take it away. However, someone could break into it easily. But again, this is just a solution to keep prying eyes out of your ammo, and also long-term storage, I believe. is what I'm using it for. It's just stuff that I'm not gonna use this ammo. I just have it here. I just have it stored here because I ran out of room in the actual ammo safe, and I didn't want to keep all of this stuff in ammo cans outside in this room. So that's how this works. And if you want to lock the Jobsite box, it's basically just a standard padlock that goes right into this hole here, and you just push it in and it locks, and you get one on each side. So that's how that works. And again, it's just to keep prying eyes out of this box. If someone wanted to get in here, they will. All right, before I end the video, I'll answer this question in this video. I don't even know if people are going to watch this video for this, but a bunch of people, because of that video that took off, this ain't no Mark 18, so many people were asking me what type of defensive load do I use in that rifle. Well, I basically use Hornady Black ammunition, this stuff here. It's a 75 grain interlock, and it's made for SBR, short barrel rifle. So the barrel on my This Ain't No Mark 18 rifle is a 10.3. So I use this, and it's mainly for home defense. And HD is not meant to stand for home defense. It's a heavy duty, but it's a 75 grain interlock round, 5.56 optimized for a shorter barrel, like a 10.3 inch. And it does quiet it down just a tad. I could tell the tone difference. I don't know how much difference it really is, but it definitely sounds different. And this is more for, you know, up close and personal. I'm talking like 30 feet, 40 feet away, maybe maximum 50 feet away for this round to perform at its optimal. But, you know, for home defense, this is a round that I would use, and it's a proven round. I used to use the TAP stuff, and I have Gold Dot hollow points that are 62 grain, I think, which are upstairs. So, but this is the round that I have at the ready for my primary defensive rifle. All right, guys, that's it. Let me know what you think about all this. Leave some comments below. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.